Italian police have released new security camera footage that shows the exact moment a massive bridge collapsed in the city of Genoa, killing 43 people. The collapse also forced the evacuation of 600 people living in buildings underneath the structure. Now this tragedy has many questioning the safety of bridges, not only there, but in cities around the world and right here in the U.S. Andy Herrmann is the former president of the American Society of Civil Engineers, and he joins me now via Skype to talk more about these concerns. So, Andy, let's start with the bridge collapse in Genoa, Italy. Do we know anything more about why this happened? Certainly, there had been warnings before.
They were actually doing some repairs to the foundation as the bridge collapsed. There's been reports that they had a lot of corrosion on their bridge. The bridge is probably 40 to 50 years old now. Some reports said they had replaced some of the cable stays in the 1980s and the 1990s. So they were working on the bridge when it did come down.
So, of course, you know, you see something like that, and we know that the president has vowed to invest in infrastructure here because there are, you know, a lot of bridges that are of concern, and not just bridges in this country. But what's the likelihood of something like that that happened in Genoa happening here in this country?
Well, in the United States, we have a law that basically requires every highway bridge to be inspected at least every 2 years. And if the inspectors find anything, they can cut that inspection frequency down. They can close the bridge. They can do emergency repairs. They can restrict the weights. So the public safety is very important in bridges in the United States.
So there's a sort of a systematic process in place then when it comes to bridges in particular. Are there enough people to keep up with that, to check on every bridge every 2 years?
Yes. The federal government does fund that bridge inspection through all the states. So every bridge is required, a highway bridge, to have a report at least every 2 years, and they check up on it. And they gather all the data, and that's how we come up with the deficiency ratings across the country, the good, the fair, and the poor bridges.
But, of course, we've had bridge collapses here. I can recall the Minnesota one is probably huge, but the most recent one was in Florida. It was a pedestrian bridge outside of Florida International University back in March. You know, remind us of what went wrong there in Florida and how investigators sort of look into these collapses, how the investigation unfolds.
Well, the Florida bridge, the National Transportation Safety Board, has teams down there looking at the results of the collapse. They'll probably take some of the pieces back to their laboratories in Washington, D.C. and analyze how things fractured. They'll do a computer analysis of all the components to see if anything was overstressed. But usually these reports take 12 to 18 months to come back. So they're still doing investigation at this point.
Are you confident that we have a reliable system in place to ensure that our bridges are safe?
With the inspection system, we will take bridges out of service if they're a public safety problem. Mm-hmm. And the inspection cycles can get reduced if they find anything wrong with the bridges. The Minnesota bridge you mentioned a little bit earlier, I-35, when they did the analysis, turned out to be a deficient design. The gusset plates, the big metal plates that hold the truss members together, apparently were half as thick as they should be. Mm. But they were working on the bridge at that time. And probably the construction loading, the traffic loading, and that deficiency probably brought it down.
So when a bridge does come down, when we've seen that happen, is it typically a design flaw that eventually over time sort of becomes increasingly vulnerable, or is it just wear and tear? I mean, how long can a bridge stand just with regular wear and tear and still maintain its structure?
There's many things that can cause a bridge failure. It could be the original materials used. It could be the construction, the details, the techniques they used. It could be the design. It could be the maintenance of the bridge. They may not be taking care of it. They may not have the funds available to do it. Bridges from that era, the 50s, 60s, were designed for a 50-year lifespan. That can be increased if you maintain the bridges and you do the proper rehabilitations. Today's bridges that we're designing, we're looking at a 75 to 100-year lifespan.
So how old's the average bridge in this country?
43 years old, okay. And 39% of our bridges are over 50 years old.
Interesting. And I just think about sort of the amount of traffic, the increase in road traffic in certain areas over, say, a 50-year span. Are some of these bridges, were they built to sustain, you know, whether it's heavy trucks or some of the heavier traffic that we can see now?
We do find, especially in metropolitan areas, that the bridge loadings that the bridges were designed for are now being exceeded. And that's why they have to take a particular close look at these bridges to make sure they're still capable of carrying the loads. In some instances, they'll reinforce bridges.
Well, I got to tell you, Andy Herrmann, you made me feel a lot more confident about the bridges in this country, because I know there's been a lot of talk about investment in infrastructure and that it's needed. You know, and it was something that the president ran on. It was part of his campaign promise. When you heard that, just to talk about the infrastructure in this country, I mean, are we dealing with a country that's challenged by aging infrastructure? Because when I listen to you, it seems like it's not that bad.
Well, I'm saying what we're doing right now, but the departments of transportation around the country don't have sufficient dollars to take care of their bridges. Sometimes they have to choose between maintenance, repairs, emergency repairs, and brand new bridges. They need more funding. And if you look at our gas tax, which is 18.4 cents for the Highway Trust Fund, goes back to 1993. That's a lot of inflation that's eating away at those dollars, and we really should be raising the gas tax.
All right, really good point. Andy Herrmann, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.